I think you have to develop a relationship first. So I don't go into someone's home that I've never seen before and introduce that idea. But you kind of have to get a feel of where they're at in their diagnosis and where they're at with their disease. And once they're ready, I do approach it as, you know, there is this doctor that we can call that will actually come to your home and help you manage your symptoms, help you manage your pain, and then we can help support you through that. And we can keep you at home if you want, as long as you want to be at home. If you decide you need to go to the hospital, we'll help you with that too. And recently we did have a case, a lady who became very sick and was diagnosed when she became very sick and felt that she was never going to get out of the hospital. They did some procedures, some palliative treatment in the hospital, and she was able to come home, and she had 2 good months at home where she was supported with her pain management and anything else she needed. She did end up dying in hospital, but she was home for longer than she thought she was going to be, and it was a really positive experience. I think her son and his girlfriend helped look after her, and she really got to enjoy that time at home, and it was time she didn't think she was going to have. So it is kind of a, you know, it's not something you go into lightly. And oftentimes that is a challenge because we don't know what people have been told when they're diagnosed. Or, you know, they've seen the oncologist, they may not have understood what that oncologist told them. And their family doctor may assume that they understood, and it doesn't really come out until, you know, you're having a conversation with this person at home that they don't really know what their diagnosis means for them. And so a lot of times we do bring in the palliative care team, and Dr. Ritter is one of our palliative care physicians, and he's very good at addressing those issues.